Thank you. Good evening to one and all. So I think most of you or all of you are my seniors. So why breast cancer? Why targeted therapy? Why an update? So breast cancer, why I'm taking this topic is these are my learning objectives for any CME or any talk. Nowadays we form learning objectives. So what are we going to see in simple topic? An introduction, a clinician nutshell for all the physicians and clinicians here, and what is targeted therapy, why breast cancer, and I'll give a general synapse. So why breast cancer? Breast cancer is unquestionably the number one cancer in the world and also in our country. Gone are the days when people used to say in rural areas cervix is common and in urban area breast cancer is common. It is not so. Breast cancer has taken over all other cancers in the world. So the rationale for doing this is per year 14 million new cases are diagnosed and 8 million people die in the whole world due to breast cancer alone, and 4 million die, this is more important, 4 million of these people die in this age group, in the most active age group, and a synapse of what is happening in cancer in India. So in males, most common cancer is cancer of the oral cavity, as you all know. And in females, it is the breast. The other cancers are common. Even if you put all cancers together, both male and female, even then breast cancer is the commonest cancer in our country. And Indian scenario, as you can see, breast cancer has a higher weightage than any other cancer, even males, females, everyone put together. Now, this is more important, as Dr. Ramkumar previously put. These are numbers from our own cancer registries. Why we talk about only Mumbai, Bangalore, Chennai, not from other rural areas is because the city cancer registries are present only in the cities, but they represent people from elsewhere, because most of the people from rural areas, they come to the city registries, and the data from all the government hospitals go to the Chennai registry, which is collected by Adyar here. So Adyar is a reputed institute which collects data, which is the most heritage, most oldest cancer registry in India. So as you can see, if you see the percentage as such, it is fairly equal in all the city registries. But as we know that the age-adjusted rates are the most sensitive way of collecting data. So if you see age-adjusted rate, Chennai tops the list. So breast cancer, most common cancer in the world, most common cancer in India, it is the most common cancer in Chennai also. So that is why I take breast cancer always. And in breast cancer, this is more bothering. 20 years back, it was only after 60 years, cancer was diagnosed. Now we can see the bars are changing. 25 years back, we see it was in the 50s to 60s. Now we can see the age is decreasing. You are clinician, you are physicians, you could have very well seen the difference. 20 years back, it was only older people who get breast cancer. Now it is not so. I see 20-year-old people with breast cancer. 25, 30. So this 30 to 40 is the most common age group in India. So between US, between America and India, you see, Indian cancer is 10 years younger than the US population. So even our cancer screening guidelines have changed. Initially it was from 50 years of age you start screening. For India, it is 35 years of age you start screening. This is the rationale for that. So we have younger cancers. So these are age-old slides. The way of screening breast cancer, breast self-examination should start at age 20. Even this terminology has changed, it is no longer breast self-examination, it is called breast awareness. Any woman, any girl who reaches the age of 18 should be aware of her breast, the contour, the size and the shape. So that is where it starts, and then clinical breast examination comes second, and then only mammograph. The recommendation is changed, it is after 35 years. Once in 1 to 3 years. So among all these, the weightage is for breast self-examination, because how many of us have undergone a breast screening by a clinical physician, ourselves or wives? I bet no one. Because even my mother, my own mother, has not gone to any doctor to get her breast exam. This is India, this is us, this is Tamil Nadu. So nobody goes for self. By self to a doctor and gets a breast examined. So our weightage is always breast self examination. If you can self-diagnose during birth, during rest, that is the best way of diagnosing breast cancer. So the first area, first point of contact for breast cancer in India is always a primary physician. They don't come directly to a hospital or directly to the cancer specialist, never. They come always to the trusted doctor, which is their primary physician. That's why I'm talking this topic to you. So, leave alone breast cancer. Now, the treatment of breast cancer, as most of us know, the number one treatment, age-old treatment is surgery. So what extra do I add? I'm a cancer chemotherapy guy, a specialist in both radiation and chemotherapy. So what extra we are adding is this one. So 35% survival difference in metastatic breast cancer is given by this chemotherapy. And if you take hormone positive metastatic breast cancer, the difference in survival is they don't take hormones. Hormones are just tablets. Tamoxifen is a tablet which is 2.5 rupees. So if they don't take the tablet, the survival, average survival is 1.5 years. If they take the tablet, the survival is 7 years. For a tablet which costs 2.50 rupees. So that is the weightage which this chemotherapy and targeted therapy gives. And when people take adjuvant chemotherapy, that is after surgery they take chemotherapy, the difference in survival is the recurrence rates is, there is a difference by 18%. So, and recently, as we progress in more of chemotherapy and radiation and targeted therapy, the difference what you get is, suppose patient has a large breast cancer and we are offering chemotherapy before surgery. What is the difference is some people, about 30% of them will achieve something called PCR, pathological complete response. So once they achieve this PCR, it is equal to cure. Means the patient will be cured of this breast cancer. The chance of recurrence is less than 2%. So suppose a patient with a large breast mass, which always happens in this country, we never have people with small breast cancer. We always have people with large cancers which are inoperable. So for these people, we do something called immunohistochemistry. We do special tests and molecularly profile them, which is not very costly, costs about 4,000 to 5,000 rupees, is this. So after this molecular profiling, we divide them into hormone positive or HER2 positive people, and we give chemotherapy or targeted therapy accordingly. So after 4 cycles, we do a surgery and we say there is no tumor left behind. It means they are getting cured, no more treatment needed. So that is how this PCR works. So this is the new thing that is happening in breast cancer. Now our chemotherapy, we give in all these 3 settings. Patients, 50% of them will be metastatic at presentation in our country. So these people, chemotherapy is a prime modality. For people who are surgically operable, after surgery we give something called adjuvant. So for people who have large breast cancer which are not operable in the primary setting, we give something called neoadjuvant chemotherapy. Now, staging of breast cancer, staging of any cancer as you know is the TNM staging, tumor, node and metastasis. That is how it was traditionally staged. Now I think the staging is changing. Breast cancer staging, if you go to a NEET exam today, breast cancer staging is no longer TNM. It is changing. The breast cancer by us, Dr. Ram Kumar before me told, tumor biology governs everything. It is not the stage. Suppose you have a stage 4 cancer who is hormone positive and who don't take treatment, they will survive for 5 years. Who take hormonal therapy, they will survive for 10 years. Stage 4 patient. Suppose we have a HER2 patient and they don't take treatment, they will die in 6 months. And if they take treatment, then also their survival is around 2 to 3 years. So where is stage? Stage is no longer there. The prognosis of breast cancer is determined by these 4 tests. ER, estrogen receptor, PR, progesterone receptor, HER2 is a new receptor, and K67 is the proliferating index. These 4 simple tests is done on the biopsy specimen, is called immunohistochemistry. These tests cost about 4,500 to 5,000 rupees extra. And in fact, it is done free in Madras Medical College, which I studied. Now, as I told, breast cancer is not a single disease. It is many diseases put together based on these hormonal markers and this HER2 marker. So based on this, we divide breast cancer into these 3 simple subtypes. So this is the current staging for breast cancer. We have luminal stage, which is hormone positive. That is, this tumor will respond to hormones. Next one is HER2 positive. They have some new molecule on the breast cancer cells called HER2. So this HER2 is a very aggressive diet. So in India, this is the world cancer era. In India, about 30% of our breast cancer people are HER2 positive. And people who don't fit into these two fall under something called triple negative. That is ER negative, PR negative, and HER2 negative. They are called the basal type. So this is the way we divide breast cancer now. Now these are all the chemotherapy regimens we give for breast cancer. No need to go through this. What guidelines we follow for breast cancer is this NCCN guidelines. Sadly, we don't have any approved guidelines in India for breast cancer as well. So we follow the American guidelines. So in American guidelines, what I do is I modify these guidelines, take only the simple regimen, practical regimen, or cheaper regimen and treat patients. And here you can see there are newer drugs. That is, you can see trastuzumab, pertuzumab. They are not chemotherapy drugs. There is something called targeted therapy. So what is this targeted therapy? Even for metastatic, you see, these are chemotherapy drugs. And on the side, you can see this trastuzumab, pertuzumab, lapatinib. These are all newer drugs which are called targeted therapy. Now, what is targeted therapy? I play video games daily with my son, so I cannot find any other way of explaining this. So what is targeted therapy is like playing a video game. If you don't know the enemy, you are hitting the normal people also. But once you know the enemy, you can hit him alone. So this is the most simple way of defining target therapy. Before 10 years, the medical oncology department or medical oncology facility was only discovering new drugs. And they find a newer derivative of the drug, increase the cost, and then increase the side effects, then find another drug with lesser side effects. This was how the research was going. Before 10 years, what happened is some intelligent guy, he started looking at the tumor rather than the drug. So take the tumor, look in the microscope, put some dyes, immunohistochemistry, newer genetic studies, and find targets. So find some molecules which are important for survival of that cell, and then find a drug for that cell. So this is how targeted therapy was discovered. As sir was asking, what is the use of genetic testing in stomach cancer? I will tell none. Because for stomach cancer, there is no approved targeted therapy. But for breast cancer, we have targeted therapy which are very cheap, as I told you, 2.50 rupees. So targeted therapy is more, the genetic testing is more sensible in breast cancer rather than any other cancer. So this is how targeted therapy works. So now what targets we have? In breast cancer, we have this ERPR, hormone target, this HER2 target, and newer targets like BRCA, breast cancer associated antigen, which is present in familial breast cancer. And this AR is androgen receptor, that is male hormones are also expressed in some breast cancer. So these are the simple targets that are present in breast cancer. So what drugs we have for these targets? ERPR, for hormones we have these targeted therapy. Tamoxifen, which is given in premenopausal ladies. Aromatase inhibitors like letrozole or anastrozole, which are given in postmenopausal people. And these two drugs, fulvestrant and palbociclib, are newer drugs. So I'm just explaining you very complex things in a very simple way. So for HER2 is a new molecule which was discovered about 7 to 10 years back. And we have all these drugs in the pipeline, that is trastuzumab, pertuzumab, TDM1 and lapatin. All these four drugs are approved. These first three drugs are American drugs which are approved. The last one is an Asian molecule, which is a tablet, which is even cheaper. So these four drugs are available for this HER2 target. Why HER2 targeting is because 30% of Indians have HER2 positive breast cancer. Without HER2 targeted therapy, the general survival is about a year, 12 to 18 months. But with HER2 targeting, the survival prolongs to 7 to 10 years, even in a metastatic breast cancer, this patient with stage 4. For stage 1 and stage 2, if you give HER2 target, they get cured. So that is the difference that this HER2 molecule made, and the HER2 discoverer got Nobel Prize also. Now, this is how this, what is this HER2? HER2 is a molecule that is present on the cell membrane. We have four types of HER molecule, that is HER1, HER2, HER3, HER4. They have the property of combining with each other. And when they combine with each other, they cause a signaling through the cell. And this signal causes survival, indefinite survival of that cell. And the cell becomes very aggressive. Now, HER1, HER2, HER3, HER4, any one can combine with each other. this HER2 and HER3 combination is the most active signal, and these drugs, the trastuzumab, pertuzumab, the most commonly used HER2 targeted drugs. Now trastuzumab acts in that area, that is subdomain 4. This pertuzumab acts in a more virulent area. So if you combine these two drugs and give it to a patient who is HER2 strong positive, the cure rate is 66%, which was never achievable for any aggressive breast cancer before. So this is how this HER2 targeting works. What other targets we have? 5% of all breast cancer are hereditable. That is, some people in their family will have breast cancer. For these hereditable breast cancers are very aggressive. They present at a very early stage, and literally we were not knowing what to do. But recently we have this oral drug called PARP inhibitors. This PARP inhibitor is an enzyme which is present inside the cell, which is responsible for cellular repair. So if you give this PARP inhibitor tablet along with chemotherapy, the cell kill becomes enhanced by 88%. So for all familial breast cancer, this PARP inhibitors are approved in India. The drugs available most commonly is this olaparib. So olaparib will, when we give along with the chemotherapy called paclitaxel, the cure rates are very, very high. Now AR targeting is even, this is also part of targeted therapy. AR is androgen receptor. Some breast cancer people, surprisingly, they have androgen receptor in them. So drugs which are used in prostate cancer, a male cancer, is used for these people with breast cancer, and they are very, very effective. So 10 years back, if you are giving these prostate cancer drugs to a breast cancer, people will be laughing at me. No longer, because 5 to 7% of all breast cancer will express these androgen receptors. So giving them these tablets makes sense. Now this triple negative, the third type which I was telling, we talked about hormone positive breast cancer, we talked about HER2 positive breast cancer. Next one is triple negative, that is all receptors are negative. We are nowhere, we cannot give any targeted therapy for them. But then there is something new called immunotherapy. This immunotherapy is given, this is a cancer directed immunity will be increased by giving immunotherapy. Any chemotherapy we give generally reduces the immunity for some time. But this immunity acts in the opposite direction, that is, it increases the immunity to cancer. So this is how this immunotherapy works. It is already approved in many cancers like lung cancer, melanoma. Now it is approved for this triple negative breast cancer people also. In our hospital, you have many people going on immunotherapy for 2, 3, 4 years, who are doing well. Why immunotherapy, why target therapy is because chemotherapy will have side effects, as you know, hair fall, you know, fatigue, blood counts will reduce, bone marrow will suppress. None of the side effects happen in targeted therapy as well as immunotherapy. So that is why people nowadays choose more of immunotherapy or targeted therapy. The only hinge factor in these new treatments is cost. So as I told you, the simple targeted therapy that I give is hormonal therapy. So if people are hormone positive, then luckily most of Indian breast cancer are hormone positive. The cost is very, very less. It is almost equal to a paracetamol that we prescribe, 2 rupees per day. So this tablet goes on for 5 years. That is part of target therapy. Next target therapy is HER2 targeted therapy, of course, which is costly, costs about 20,000 to 30,000 rupees per cycle. But most of the, even the Tamil Nadu government has approved these targeted therapies, and nowadays most of the patients are covered by health insurance. If you don't have health insurance, please get a health insurance, because health is very, very costly nowadays, especially disease like cancer. So this is how this targeted therapy works, and this is our multidisciplinary team in New York. We work as a team. We have the largest number of targeted therapies and immunotherapies in the country. And have I covered all the learning objectives? I gave an introduction and a clinical nutshell, and what is targeted therapy, why it is used in breast cancer, and a general synapse. Thank you. Any questions?
Doctor, you said three types. One is luminal, another is HER2 positive, and third one.
Triple.
Among the three, which has the good prognosis?
Better prognosis. Luckily, hormone positive breast cancer.
Okay.
My grandmother had hormone positive breast cancer. She was diagnosed 15 years back. as in any other female, she refused to go to the hospital. She never went to any hospital. And we gave her only tablet, hormone therapy. So this tablet she's taking and she's living now.
And about this HER2 positive and negativity depends on the accuracy of the laboratory. Suppose it is borderline, how do you judge whether the patient needs HER2 treatment?
So HER2, first we do a simple test. So like any histology, we put a dye and see immunohistochemistry. So that is low cost test, which costs about 2,000 rupees. So if that is strong positive, 3 plus, then we start targeted therapy. If it is 1 plus, it is taken as negative. This 2 plus is what sir is telling.
Borderline.
For borderline, we do another test called FISH test, in situ hybridization. So that is, we don't do it initially because it is quite costly. It costs about 8,000 rupees. So we do this immunohistochemistry first. If there is any doubt, we do a FISH test.
FISH test, CASH.
CASH is after FISH test. Even in FISH, if it is equivocal, then we do chromophore probes. That is the next level.
Regarding the TNM staging, see, if you are not going to do the tumor nodal metastasis, how are you going to stage the disease and decide your treatment? This DR, PR and others will tell you how effective your hormone treatment is going to be, or the chemo. It's a guide to you and also a prognostic factor. But regarding the management, you say it's going to be early breast cancer, stage 1 and 2, locally advanced or advanced. So that, unless you do the TNM, you cannot. So I don't think you can say
we
can knock.
No, I'm just trying to stress on this.
It's exactly what
the
I'm
saying. First initial staging is just simply palpate the breast. If the breast is immobile, then it becomes locally advanced breast cancer. We do a metastatic workup. If there is metastasis, it is going to be metastatic breast cancer. Now there is only 3 stages: early stage, locally advanced stage, and metastatic.
Yeah.
So
that depends only on the TNM. Tumor node metastasis, this early
one
and thing. So we cannot say no
TNM
staging.
For the surgeon, it's always TNM. For guys like me.
No, I don't think it can vary from person to person.
The treatment decision, as madam is telling, is based on TNM stage. Oh. But the prognosis.
That's exactly what I'm saying.
How people are going to behave. That is the first question I'm encountered with. People sit in front of me and ask me horoscope. How long I'm going to survive? That is the first question. For me, this makes sense.
I request Dr. Prem Chandra, please come and hand a certificate of appreciation to Dr. Suman Kalyan.